Alright guys, welcome to another beer review, and I do apologise if you hear a vibrating sound, and I've realised I haven't muted YouTube, because I'm just currently watching Good Beer Live with my good friends Rob from Hop Scene, Jake from Jacob Beer, and Craig from Kent Beer Reviews. Links, if I remember, will be down below. But yeah, so we're actually going up Yorkshire way, and we're having a look at the Yorkshire Square Ale. That's gone a bit mank, hasn't it? But yeah, so apologies to both Stuart and Rob for that, and of course anybody else from up Yorkshire way who's watching this. I am an absolute wreck of a person, and I'm deeply ashamed. But today we're going up to the Black Sheep Brewery, and we're having a look at the Yorkshire Square Ale, born and bred in Masham, Yorkshire. 5% ABV, superbly dry and full-bodied, a long-lasting, crisp, bitter finish. So this is Yorkshire Square Ale, a tribute to the fermenting system we use at Black Sheep, originated from West Riding of Yorkshire over 200 years ago. This word brewing method utilises double-decked vessels made of slate, which help give our beers their characteristic crisp, dry flavour and underline our commitment to quality brewing. So I would imagine then that this might be a pale ale or a best bitter or something along those lines. It doesn't actually go into what the beer is, to be honest. But yeah, 5% ABV. I am a fan of Black Sheep. Their Black Sheep, is it just the Black Sheep Ale, is a personal favourite of mine. It's one of the few beers that I can actually drink with my mum, which is a very rare occasion, because when would you want to drink with your mother on a regular basis? Not going to judge anybody who does so, because surely that's better than sitting in a bedroom drinking on your own. Couldn't even do a thumbs up straight away. That's the sort of wreck that I am, both physically and mentally. And I've got something on my glasses which haven't been cleaned for about a few weeks now, so what I believe to be impaired vision is just glasses that need to be cleaned. But yes, I'm a big fan of Black Sheep Brewery, and yeah, their Black Sheep Ale is one of my personal favourites. Saw this in Aldi, and I think Aldi are doing a sort of beer festival type thing. Yeah, that's Great England. And I think it changes depending on which part of the country you go to. Because I know in Scotland they do like a Scottish beer festival. But that being said, Aldi gets some really interesting beers in on a regular basis, but also seasonally. So I picked up a few today. And yeah, not had a Black Sheep beer for quite a while, so I thought I'd give one a go. So yeah, there's the crown. I do really like that artwork. It looks very nice. Judging by the colour of it, it could actually be sort of like a red amber ale or something like that. But apparently the artwork is credited to Mackenzie Thorpe. I'm not too sure what that's in relation to. But yeah, Black Sheep Brewery, nice crown. Let's get the beer open and see what we get. Obviously messed that up. Nice amount of smoke there. Can't really see it on camera. So, using my Beer Moth Tulip glass for this. And it's pouring pale. So, I was almost there. So, let's see what we get with this one. So, I poured that a little bit aggressively. But, beer in the glass then. And that's got a lovely sort of deep amber hue to it. But golden at the same time. Lovely clarity, as you can see. Looks a bit more vibrant on camera. But I poured it with about two fingers worth of maybe an ever so slightly off-white head. But yeah, you know, that actually could be classed as an amber ale, I suppose. I'm not too sure. I've not really had too many real ales for quite a while, actually. So I thought I'd make the most of what was available in Aldi and give them a go. And I know that Black Sheep are a reliable brewery. Well, at least I think so. So anyway, it looks really nice, so let's see what we get on the nose. Just getting a lot of musk, it has to be said. A little bit of a... slight sweetness in there. It's grassy, it's wheaty. Now it's breathing in the glass, there's a bit more of a spiciness coming out. Maybe a subtle floral, almost citrus edge coming from those hops. But yeah, it just smells like a simple sort of golden ale or something to along those lines. But that being said, a little bit of mandarin coming through and a little bit of an orange aroma. Anyway, let's see what it tastes like. Cheers. Do you know what? It's got like a flavour of love hearts to it. There's like a slight sweet, sherbety, confectionery edge there. It's not a really citrusy beer. I wouldn't say it's a really hoppy beer by any stretch. It's crisp, it's golden, a little bit of biscuitiness in there. But there's like this subtle sweetness, candy-like sweetness almost. Lovely and crisp. It's not an exciting beer by any stretch. It's a very simple, concise sort of beer. But does every beer have to be overtly complex? Does every beer have to be in your face in one way or the other? What's wrong with just a nice, simple, sessionable chugger? And this definitely has that vibe about it. It's got like an autumnal vibe to it. There's like this very subtle, sweet treacle-like character, but then it doesn't get too sweet. There's a little bit of an earthy dryness in there as well, but again, doesn't go too far into that direction. Little bit of a citrusy hop character coming through, but again, nice and subtle. It's a very grounded, easy drinking beer. And yeah, I'm going to happily demolish the rest of that. It's not going to last for long. It's a little bit sweeter than you would expect. That's all I'm going to say. It's probably the only thing that's a tiny nitpick is I wouldn't really want to drink too much of this. But I tell you what, autumn, Halloween is fast approaching us. You know, bonfire night, that sort of stuff. If you had a few bottles of this in the house, yeah, it fits that sort of environment and time of the year. That being said, you can have this at the height of summer and it's still going to be a satisfying beer. Would I go out my way to get another bottle of this straight away? I don't think so. So it just gets underneath that 7 out of 10. So I'm going to give it a 6.75 out of 10. It's not my favourite beer from Black Sheep by any stretch. But I'm glad that I gave it a go and went back to the Black Sheep Brewery because it's a brewery that I've not drank from for a long time and I need to get myself, especially with Christmas a couple of months away. Way to completely make your video unwatchable once it's been uploaded, Peter. Yeah, great way to date a video and make it irrelevant. But yeah, come Christmas time, get yourself a few of the Black Sheep ales. I always forget if it's just called Black Sheep Ale or if there's something else. It's the one with the sort of like, it's got like a beigey label or pale beige label that sort of looks like a sack or parchment, and it's just got bold letters Black Sheep Ale. I think that's what it is. That's a beer that I've not had for quite a while, and I really did enjoy that one. But yeah, it's nice to revisit a brewery that I've not tried for in a long time, and from what I can see, they're getting a little bit experimental with a sort of like a pilot brewing kit that they've got. I think it's like the Barrel Series or something like that. I know Rob from Hop Scene has reviewed a couple, and Simon from Real Ale Craft Beer. But yeah, as real ales go, it's trad. But it's not bad. There we are. And do you know what? Some of my favourite beers are traditional sort of beers. So I'm not going to use that as even a talking point in relation to the beer. So yeah, if you see it, give it a go. I could see a lot of people really loving this. I could see people thinking it's really boring. It's going to be one of those quite decisive beers, I suppose. But a little bit on the safe side. Easy drinking. But I'm not going to complain. 6.75 out of 10. If you've tried it, let me know your thoughts, opinions down below. Are you a fan of the brewery? Are you a fan of these types of beer? Then let me know your thoughts, opinions. And yeah, thank you for watching. If any of my friends have failed beer tubers I reviewed this one, their links will be included down below. And I shall hopefully see you all later. Cheers.